to the room flexing. Answer the question to the mortal man, what's the afterlife like? Was the pain searing when you steering towards the bright light? Maybe it was pitch black, peering to the nightlife. Underground sewer dwellers, who could tell us where the felons end up? And when your melon starts swelling, hope it lets up, caught in the pressure. And the white light facing a tunnel and distant memories funneling for the fortified hunters and the runners that elevated the gates for benevolent pioneers. The outer realm is magnificent when it's clear. We pondering on the motors that motivate, make decisions. My visions are at a slower pace. I envision serenity. Anything less would be sensibly irrational. Chasing my charity, it's after you. Facing the clarity, awfully sobering, hoping it's over when you sleep. Then you wake up to the beat.
So we let the thought descend to the cortex, process down the space and context. Context.
Night and day, life and death. Talk to God if it's too complex.
And so let's swim the void, spin through the vortex. Avenge the endless thoughts of what's next, what's next.
And extend that last breath. Show your cards, tell the stars what's left.
Yo, no matter, mineral man, a machine. A phantom energy beam is sharing my dream. I stay singular, tingling with sensation. And put my fingers up, pointing at the space station. Then beyond and trace the face of all heavenly. Witness the end when it tends to rend memories obsolete. Just the darkness enormous, the forces that formed us from the pure rawness of a million stars of possibility. Or benevolent gods with hostility. So is it really that hard to contemplate the constantly evolving altered state of an existence? We're on and gone in an instant. Stay calm and brace yourself with philosophy. Or let go, electromagnetic, the compass bag. Ready to get packed with assumptions. So we let the thought descend to the cortex, process down the space and context. Context.
Night and day, life and death. Talk to God if it's too complex.
And so let's swim the void, spin through the vortex. Avenge the endless thoughts of what's next, what's next.
And extend that last breath, yeah. Show your cards, tell yeah. the stars what's left. It's like exhale. I took my last breath, oxygen leaving my carcass, traveling, guided directly by the northern lights. Without a physical being, seeing it, time is condensed. Thought is integrated, mastery sense.
When I'm leaving the earth and eternally slumbering, my first plan is circle the planet, its circumference. I can give a damn if laws and patterns and the numbers are against me. Archaic Academy alumnus.
Omnipotent, abstract, sensory, panoramic view, never skewed by the influence of another hub of cosmos, looking to the centuries, riding as a passenger, passing through in your memories.
I was the best man at weddings, emasculate, worst laid plans if anybody invested in the long term. The last moments of anatomy get slow burn, but then you get to see the galaxy. So we let the thought descend to the cortex, process down the space and context. Context.
Night and day, life and death. Talk to God if it's too complex.
And so let's swim the void, spin through the vortex, avenge the endless thoughts of what's next, what's next.
And extend that last breath, show your cards, tell the stars what's left.
They do not offer proof of life after death, but their reports give us a new perspective on the possibility that death is not an ending, but a beginning.